morning, everyone. Thank you very much, Madam Chair, and Senator Lewis, Chairman Lewis, and members of our Committee on Public Health. I want to thank Mary Lou Sutters, our Secretary of Health and Human Services, and Maureen Gallagher, who is the face of Jane Doe and the member organizations that you work with every day, and present to you sort of a snapshot on what we're seeing through our work relative to domestic violence in our Commonwealth. And I also want to thank your colleagues, 133, who signed a resolution to bring a further statement forward about our collective feeling that we should do everything we can to tamp down domestic violence, violence in the workplace, violence in homes, and as legislative and executive branch leaders, to work together to obviously continue to find ways to do our work in a meaningful way. We were able to identify 30 partners, both law enforcement, administration, and the advocacy and service groups, to come forward and advise the executive office about how we can do more work relative to prevention, relative to services to support victims of domestic violence, and ways that we can be more effective of holding perpetrators accountable for their actions. On the public safety start, I just want to bring attention to one particular thing that came out of the work groups, and that was to form a municipal police toolkit. Okay, so you obviously are aware with police officers responding to a domestic call, that is one of the most difficult and challenging times for a police officer to go to one of those calls. When that person goes to a call, we want them to be able to respond in a uniform fashion from the municipal level. First of all, make sure that the victim is safe. Second of all, make sure that the victim is able to access the services that he or she needs to get into a place where they can find the help that they need. Not just make them safe and then walk away, but safety and the support that they need. And then doing an assessment, asking a set number of questions in a uniform manner across municipal police departments, will allow municipal police officers to gather information that can then be transferred to the court system and allow the victim and the courts to work together to hold the perpetrator accountable, to reduce the amount of repeat offenses that we are seeing all too often here in our Commonwealth. That is being piloted in Quincy, Woburn, Foxborough, and Greenfield. And once that pilot program is perfected, we're looking at taking that literally on the road. And I think this would be a really great initiative for members of the legislature to help us build this toolkit network across the Commonwealth. Obviously, we continue to partner with your caucuses, the Asian, Women's, Black, and Latino Caucus, for helping marginalized communities. We need to continue to do that. The MPTC, the Mass Police Training Council, worked closely with our administration to update the law enforcement domestic violence guidelines. Those are now embedded in municipal police training and are providing new recruits and officers across our Commonwealth with the most up-to-date ways to address domestic violence calls. So it just underscores that we still have so much work to do, and we will need to continue to work together to do that. I think it's important for all of us to come together at this point to think about how we have a more open and public and honest conversation around violence, in particular domestic violence.